Many of you like my videos where I tested how optimized a DAW is for Apple Silicon chips. Most notably, I discovered that Logic Pro 10 was not able to fully utilize the efficiency cores in Apple Silicon chips. Now that Logic Pro 11 is here, I've conducted some tests to see if there are any improvement on that front. The chips I tested Logic Pro 11 on were the 10-core M1 Max chip, which has 2 efficiency cores and 8 performance cores, and the 10-core M2 Pro chip, which has 4 efficiency cores and 6 performance cores. Note that the 10-core M1 Max chip has the exact same CPU as the 10-core M1 Pro chip, so they are synonymous in this testing context. I did return my M3 Pro MacBook Pro because, well, as my review video showed, it simply wasn't much of an upgrade when it comes to audio processing compared to my M1 Max machine. However, it doesn't really matter that I cannot test the M3 Pro chip today because if Logic Pro 11 cannot use the efficiency cores in the M1 Max chip or the M3 Pro chip, it's very likely that it won't be able to use the ones in the M3 series chips either. To test Logic Pro 11's multi-core utilization, I first put a mono guitar on a track, then I put one instance of FabFilter Saturn 2 as an insert on the track. FabFilter's plugins have been fully optimized for Apple Silicon chips pretty much since these chips first came out, so Saturn 2 won't bottleneck the performance. I set it to Superior's oversampling mode, so it would be more taxing on the CPU. And then, I duplicated the track with the plugin as many times as possible until Logic Pro gave me the system overload pop-up when I tried to play all the tracks back at the same time. I would then delete one track, hit play to see if Logic Pro could play back smoothly. If so, I would note down the track count. If not, I would keep deleting tracks until Logic could playback smoothly, and then note down the track count. To take thermal throttling into account, I always ran the test for at least 15 minutes to fully warm up the laptop chassis before recording the results. Processing threads in Logic is set to 10, and processing buffer range is set to large. Now, in my other Mac testing videos, I've gotten comments saying that duplicating a track with one plugin like that is not representative of a real-life mixing scenario. You're right. No one does that in real life. However, the way the DAW uses the cores in the chip is the same. So in my M2 Pro MacBook Pro testing video, I tested a scenario where there are all kinds of plugins not only on the individual tracks, but also on the master bus. This is much more similar to what mixing is like in real life, right? And guess what? The DAWs that could fully utilize both the efficiency cores and the performance cores performed better than the ones that couldn't on the same chip. So even though duplicating a track with one plugin many times isn't a real-life scenario, the results you get from it reflect the level of performance you can get from an Apple Silicon chip. I really hope that makes sense, and if you disagree, well, I truly don't know what to tell you. This video is probably just not for you. And that's okay. So the short answer is that, unfortunately, Logic Pro 11 bears no improvement when it comes to core utilization. This is Logic Pro 11 running at 1024 buffer with as many tracks with Saturn 2 on it as possible, and you can see that the 2 efficiency cores in the M1 Max and the 4 efficiency cores in M2 Pro are not fully maxed out. And yet, when I created one more track, Logic would give me the system overload pop-up. Here's a side-by-side comparison between Logic Pro 10 and Logic Pro 11 running the same test on a 10-core M2 Pro chip. And you can see that efficiency core utilization, or the lack thereof, is the same. Unsurprisingly, the performance Logic Pro 11 can get out of the chip is exactly the same as Logic Pro 10. In this case, both Logic versions could run about 145 instances of tracks with Saturn 2 before Logic was overloaded. Just like what my other testing video showed, Logic Pro 11 was able to do more audio processing on the M1 Max than on the 10-core M2 Pro because the M1 Max chip has more performance cores. In this case, Logic Pro 11 performed 20% better on the M1 Max chip compared to the 10-core M2 Pro chip. Next, I ran the same Saturn test but changed the buffer size to 64. Neither Logic Pro 10 nor Logic Pro 11 fully used the efficiency cores on either the M1 Max chip or the 10-core M2 Pro chip. To cover more grounds, I also ran the test with one of the new plugins that comes with Logic Pro 11, which is ChromaGlow. It's also a saturation plugin like Saturn 2, but with a lot less features. Sad news for us, ChromaGlow also didn't make full use of the efficiency cores in Apple Silicon chips. As you can see here, at 1024 buffer size, the efficiency cores are just chilling. If I duplicate one more track, Logic would give me the system overload pop-up. What's interesting though is that I could run more tracks with ChromaGlow on the M2 Pro chip compared to on the M1 Max chip. At 1024 buffer size, Logic Pro 11 was able to handle 64 tracks with ChromaGlow on the M2 Pro chip versus 60 tracks on the M1 Max chip. At 64 buffer size, it's 65 tracks on the M2 Pro versus 63 tracks on the M1 Max chip. I ran these tests multiple times so that at the very least on my end is not some one-off glitch. The differences were quite small, but it's the first time in my Mac testing experience that this happened. In all my previous Logic tests, the chip with more performance cores always beat the ones with less. So I don't know what happened here. Did Apple optimize ChromaGlow to run more efficiently on M2 Pro's 6 performance cores? Or is it that M2 Pro's 6 performance cores combined are actually more powerful than M1 Max's 8 performance cores combined this whole time, but it's just that very few plugins were able to fully maximize M2 Pro's performance cores until now? I truly have no idea, but feel free to share your thoughts in the comments. The main takeaway from today's testing is that for Logic users looking to buy an Apple Silicon Mac, you need to be looking at the performance core count and not the total core count when choosing an Apple Silicon chip, because Logic mostly runs on performance cores only. That's it for this video. Give it a like if you find it helpful so more people can see it, and subscribe for more videos on music production, tech, and content creation. I'll always appreciate your support. Stay creative, and I'll see you next time.